Here's our friend Doug's display. Well, there's a familiar face.
Hey!
Good morning.
You got here a little earlier than you expected.
Yeah, too early. We got into the hotel at 4:30 in the morning.
Oh, my.
I got a whole 2 hours of sleep.
Yeah, I just finished out on this spring.
Let that one run nice. This one's nice and quiet.
Oh, that's my little solenoid engine.
I know. I know it is. Here's Ken Wolf's collection. He's always got some goodies. Here's Troy's Swan. Great running engine. How are you, Bob?
Good. Thank you.
Well, as you can see, Mike was able to get this Callahan going. Now we'll slow it down a little. Callahan's a real fine one.
Let's go back to the other way.
Ready?
So what's that? I turned it required the other way. I'm not over here. I'm not going to lie.
Well, here's my store number one. And a half horsepower shift, both running off of that little fish tank air bubble pump that you see in the back of the car here. It's almost enough air to keep them both moving all the time. This one will stop until this one reaches top or bottom dead center, and then it starts again. It's a balancing act. Now this Stuart 9 will also run on the same. I can show you that. Actually, it needs a little more airflow. Thank you.
time.
Here we'll have a look at the Bruce Macbeth engine, the Cool Spring Power Museum. And over here, this might be a three-ball climber. Let's take a look around the front. It's a flying twin, 125 horsepower. Here's a real bike. a nice running Type B spring. He's got a Pedro style terminal. He has a charge of fuel and a charge of fire. Right there.